So I am back again with another storytime video, Dave Firestone. And today we're going back to the frat house I was in college for the final storytime video of February 2021. And I was reminded of this recently and I figured this is going to be a good story, so here we go. Now as I said, I talked about a few of the whole issues that I had with my roommates when I was living in the frat house. Truth be told, those were all really nice guys. I really did like all of them. We were all friends. It's just the partying was just too much sometimes. So, after the whole, like, nearly getting evicted thing, we were mellow for a decent bit. And then spring break happened. And we were just... A few of us traveled, I stayed home, and a few of us stayed home. And we were just hanging out one day, and there was a possibility of a family get-together that I kind of wanted to go to, but it had been sort of ping-ponging back and forth over whether or not it would actually happen. So on this particular day, I would get the phone call about whether or not it was actually going to go. So I'm just like, okay, I'm going to play Counter-Strike and wait by the phone, because I had three phones at the time. I had the landline that was in my dorm room. I had my old cell phone, which I hated and I sincerely regret ever getting. It was a Sprint business model. It never worked where I needed it to work. And I finally paid it off and got rid of it. And then I have the number that's now my current number. So I didn't know. Ooh, that was a hiccup. I didn't know which of the phones I would be getting the call from, so I'm like, I got all my phones ready, and I'm just playing Counter-Strike. And a little while into it, one of my roommates comes in, and for the purposes of this story, I'm going to name him Tucker. So Tucker was the kind of guy he liked to drink too, but he was the polar opposite of Bluto from the last story. Like, Bluto would just get drunk and do the craziest, stupidest things. Tucker was the kind of guy, he would just drink and he'd just be the most mellow guy in the world. So, Tucker comes up to me and says, hey, we're going to have some fun in the backyard. You want to come? And I'm like, as soon as I get the call, I'll be done. Because they sort of knew what was going on. And I'm like, yeah, I'd like to, but I want to make sure I get this call first. I'm like, okay. So about 5 minutes later, I hear them outside and they're playing a game that they invented that they called Tree Ball. Now, here's the premise. You get a tennis ball and a group of friends and a tree. The group of friends stand around the tree. The person who is it throws the tennis ball up into the tree. Whoever it lands closest to gets to be it. And then they get to throw the tennis ball. If you are physically hit by the tennis ball, you are out. I mean, it sounds boring, but it's actually kind of a fun way to spend a Saturday afternoon. And there's like four of them out there, and they're just goofing around, and I'm like, okay, fine. So I go back to playing Counter-Strike, and I'd say maybe 10, 15 minutes after they started, I hear a sound that can only be described as a billiard ball hitting concrete. Like, if you dropped a billiard ball on the sidewalk, that's what the sound that I heard was. And I get up and I go to the window and I see that Tucker is lying on the ground. His head is near the concrete sidewalk we had and he's bleeding. So I'm like, okay, he fell and hit his head. Which, you know, some people might consider that to be stupid. But who among us has not fallen over while playing any form of sporting? God, I just cannot talk tonight. Who among us has not fallen over while playing sports once in their lives? None of us. It all happens. So I'm like, okay, I gotta call the paramedics on this guy. And the rest of my roommates are freaking out, screaming, call 911, call 911. So I call 911, and I explain what happened. I said, okay, he was playing ball with some friends, and he slipped, and he hit his head on the cement. Could you please send an ambulance? Sure. And the ambulance comes, they take him to the hospital. And I'm thinking, okay, that's going to be the end of it. I think he had a mild concussion and he had some stitches he needed. And I'm just like, okay, fine, whatever. It is what it is. It sucks, but it is what it is. A little while later, after I get the call confirming that the get-together has in fact been postponed, I go downstairs, and I'm just chatting with one of the other guys, and I'm like, what happened with Tucker out there? And one of the other guys looks at me and goes, you didn't know what happened? And I said, no, I thought he just slipped and hit his head on the cement. And he's like, no, that's not what happened. I'm like, well, what happened? It turns out that the story is a lot dumber than I could have ever anticipated. Because when I say that the point of tree ball is to throw a ball up into a tree and it bounces off the branches and it lands close to you or hits you, I specifically said it was a tennis ball or a racquetball. For reasons I cannot understand, number one, we didn't have any of these handy for whatever reason, because we were swimming in them, like, at one point in the year. But they decided that they're going to do this anyway, and even, like, a soccer ball would have made sense. You know what they used? A solid wooden croquet ball. And as soon as he said that to me, I go, oh, no. And that's exactly what happened. They were fooling around, they threw this solid wooden croquet ball up into a tree, it bounced off all the branches, and slammed Tucker in the head. And I'm just like, what is wrong with you? Well, we wanted to play the game. Dude, you have a soccer ball. Why not use that?
Well, it's not as good as a croquet, it's not as good as a small,
and I'm like, so he's going to go to the hospital, he's going to have several $1,000 worth of medical expenses just because he wanted to play with a wooden ball. Well, yeah. Ugh. And it's just, to this day, I just don't get that kind of stupid. I mean, I get being bored. Like I get just being bored on a Saturday afternoon wanting to go out and have some fun. Okay, fine. I get not having the thing that you want to play specifically so you're improvising, fine. But when you're doing it in a way that's pretty much guaranteed to end in disaster, I'm kind of surprised anybody thought anything different was going to happen. You have no one to blame but yourself, and I don't feel bad for you. Like, as much as I like Tucker, he was a really nice guy. But if he's willing to go along with this, then he's an idiot. If you get out of one of the clown cars, you're a clown, okay? Sorry, hate to be the one to say that, but yeah, so that's sort of what it's like to live in a frat house where people don't have any real control. For next week, we're going to go back to high school and an issue I encountered in a student play. I'm Dave Farson, leave a like, comment, share, and subscribe, and I'll see you next week.